fallen down and they have worshiped Satan. That's why they have their position. And the beast gets its authority and great power from the dragon. So even becoming the mouth of the beast is not going to change a thing. That's where we are in history prophecy. So it's prophecy reality watch. That's what we're talking about today.
And the reason people don't understand what's really happening in the world today, the basis for their understanding is not the scriptures. If they were basing their understanding and watching the world in the context of Bible prophecy, they would clearly see what's going on. We have several things that have been happening in the world for quite a while. A couple of decades of criticism about the Federal Reserve, small bits of pieces of revelation that the Federal Reserve is not owned by the federal government? What do you mean it's not owned by the federal government? Yes, it's owned by foreign investors. Well, who are these foreign investors? Well, they're Jews. When in reality, on page 160 of the book Rulers of Evil by F. Tupper Saucy, we find that the Rothschilds are Vatican agents, the guardians of the Vatican treasury.
That's the most
carefully held secret on the planet today. The papacy controls the Federal Reserve, and now we have politicians criticizing the Federal Reserve. We want to audit the Federal Reserve. We want all this criticism and condemnation for the downfall of the economics of this country to be blamed on the Federal Reserve system, simply to prepare Americans to accept the global Federal Reserve system as some kind of financial salvation for this country. Everybody's worried about losing their jobs, their pensions, their Social Security, their food, and the clothes on their back, and the roof over their head, and they're going to accept whatever comes down the pike, and the Pope's had it ready to go for a long time, and the politicians all know about it. We're going to come into a new economic system, and I believe the papacy may even reach into her diabolical bag of tricks and pull up an amnesty, a financial amnesty, or some kind of a jubilee, and forgive the national debts of all the bankrupt nations of the world.
Well, they have to, Tom, because what can't be paid won't be paid. You just can't keep loaning people more money to pay debt.
What the American people need to realize is when this amnesty comes, the bait will be set, the trap will be set, and anybody of any common sense will say, we must go with this new financial system. And when the World Central Bank gets control, then anybody who rebels against this new world order government of the Pope will have imposed upon him economic sanctions. You will not be able to buy or sell or do anything in this world. You'll be persecuted from stem to stern. You will be running counter to the wishes of the entire world, no matter what religion they are. And this is the persecution and the inquisition that's coming to this country, because God's people know that God loves a fair balance, that we have gone into apostasy. We've completely departed from his law, and we're going headlong the wrong direction, and the whole world will be against us.
That's right.
They already are.
Well, yeah, here's the deal. Here's another chapter out of this, a couple sentences. The final push for the end game started with the formation of the Council of the Religious Institutions of the Holy Land in 2005. This council has Muslims, Jews, Catholics, and claim to be Christians in its governing body. Now, when they set up their interreligious peace plan to bring peace to the whole world, to unite the three great monotheistic religions of the world, and that is Muslims, Jews, and Christians.
And claim to be Christians.
Yeah, well, that's Catholics. That see, when they say Christians, they mean Catholics, and these claim to be Christians accept the Pope as their big daddy, you know, their father.
We're talking about the ecumenical evangelibellies.
Right.
Rome doesn't even regard them as Christians.
And see, now remember
that they're just lending their power and strength unto the beast to get this done.
Remember the temptation that Messiah was tempted with when he was taken up to the pinnacle of the temple, and he was shown all the kingdoms of this world. I will give you these if you fall down and worship me. All of these men that are involved in this, they have fallen down and worshipped at the feet of Satan. That's right. A sign to us, because they believe that they can do this through flesh and blood government of men, that they can bring about the kingdom of God and heaven on earth.
A worldly kingdom.
That's right, but it's going to be corrupt. And, you know, when the Messiah said the violent take it by force, they're going to take it, they're going to bring it by force. And there's going to be peace, yes, but it's going to be Pax Romana, the
That's right.
Roman peace. And they demonstrated what Roman peace is when the Roman government, back in Messiah's time, had crucifix works erected, and anyone who broke the peace ended up on those crucifix works. They demonstrated what Pax Romana was during the Inquisitions. Anyone who went against the grain, anyone who did not accept the Big Daddy Pope as their father, the Holy Father, they were burnt at the stake. Just a smaller version of the crucifix works of Pax Romana. And it's coming again.
Rome never changes. She's going to kill the blood of the saints.
Now, if any believers, you know, in Messiah are listening to this and they're hearing it for the first time, this sounds fantastic. But, you know, open your eyes. Everyone knows that something's in the air, that things are changing. America is changed, irrevocably changed. It will never be the same. It will never be what it was. The track has started. The second beast is speaking as a dragon, and that dragon speech is just going to get tougher and tougher. And that means the laws are changing. When a beast or a government speaks, it speaks by its laws. And that's obvious, starting with the Patriot Act, to now they can arrest, our president can kill and arrest you for just because he wants to. He has that power. I believe they just passed that stuff, and everybody's talking about it in the so-called Patriot movement. And proper, the financial district is a separate city-state from Great Britain of its own, of course, owned and controlled by the Vatican.
That's
Washington,
right.
D.C., you know, those tricky workers behind the scenes, you know, ceded that property when they formed the Constitution of the United States government, knowing that if they got the control and the power of the United States in one place, that they could control it. And that's the whole reason I propose. That's the whole reason for the Civil War, because the South was slipping away from the control of their city-state, Washington, D.C., and they had to fight to get it back and keep control over the entire continent here in the United States. So there's two city-states, and of course, the Vatican is a separate city-state. It's separate from Italy itself. It received its status back in 1929. That's when the wound that the head received in 1788 was healed, wound healed, in 1929, of February of 1929, and they celebrate that in the Vatican every year. They have a little celebration of how their position was restored on the world scene. And so here they are with all this power, and they control all the money, and they're getting ready to pull off their play. It's being set up in the world right now. The Antichrist is starting to move, and the moves are becoming public. The public hasn't
right.
been aware so far. And as we talked about, the monetary system, most people don't have a clue that the Federal Reserve is not federal. It's not part of the U.S. government, but it's run by, you know, the Vatican bankers over there from the financial district, that city-state called London. And why are most people ignorant? That's because if you remember your public school education, they don't teach you law in public school. They could teach every child in the public school, give them a course on law, but they don't want to. They like their monopoly on the law, and they like to keep people ignorant. They even like to keep the lawyers ignorant, the ones that go to law school to get their degree in law. But they could teach every child law, and that was part of the education of most early Americans that got into government. Anyone could become a lawyer just by studying the law themselves.
It was certainly a primary education in Israel, wasn't it?
Yeah, so law, they want to keep you dumb. And they don't teach you about money, how money works. It's all a mystery. They teach you how to add and subtract money and how to count money and how to give change. Perhaps you might work in a McDonald's or something, and that might be important. So they teach you that, but they don't teach you about money, how it comes from, how it works, where it works. But now in early America, they didn't need to teach you about money because an ounce of gold was worth $20 and an ounce of silver was worth $1. That wasn't too hard to figure out. That was substance. But it all started to become a mystery after the Federal Reserve. And they took all the gold away, and then money just became a mystery by the time, you know, I was in elementary and junior and high school and back in the 60s, 70s, 50s or whatever, that I didn't learn anything about money, how it worked, where it came from. It all became a mystery. They kept us all dumbed down. So they didn't teach us about money. They didn't teach us about law. And now they have a dumbed down America that doesn't have a clue. And it's all by design, Tom.
It certainly is. The destruction of God's people, to cause God's people to do that which God most abhors, to violate his law, and to worship men and systems rather than a holy father, a benevolent, loving, heavenly father.
So I've got some ideas. Well, go ahead. I'll let you finish your thought.
Well, the truth seems strange only because we've been indoctrinated with a fiction, a futurist fiction. And we've just simply followed our lying shepherds to corruption, total apostasy.
Yeah, and what's even worse than that is these lying shepherds don't even know that they're lying because they've been trained to lie. Most of them don't have a clue. But why can't they see the truth? Well, because they've made compromises and they become compromised by the system by receiving benefits from it. And we've all been partakers. I have in the past been a partaker in the system and taking benefits and deceived thereby. And that's what keeps you trapped. Once they get you hooked on those benefits and you can't let go of them, they make you their slave. And out of fear, out of lack of faith, you end up staying in. And that's what's, you know, that's how Satan's monetary system works by design. Because so many things become necessary with a fiat usury monetary system. Welfare becomes necessary, Tom, because there's not enough money to pay the usury. You know, if every dollar is loaned into existence and you have to pay back more than you loaned, see, there's always a deficit, so it brings about poverty, and welfare is necessary. The income tax is necessary for a fiat usury monetary system because they have to be able to collect on the debt somehow. And so they rob the people and there's even less money. So they have to have debt forgiveness like bankruptcy laws and all of these unlawful things according to God's law, Social Security, all these things become a necessity under the fiat usury monetary system. That's why the Vatican loves communism so much. They are the author of it through Satan's monetary system. And as my good friend Alfred says, he says, what can't be paid won't be paid. And you were talking about that you have this feeling that they're going to have a jubilee of a sort.
Yes.
And they're going to have a jubilee, Tom.
Yes, they have to.
Yeah, on a national scale, they're going to have a jubilee. I don't believe they're going to forgive private debts, but they're going to forgive national debts because they have no choice. And as you said, the whole world is going to go after it. And as an enticement, when they finally set up their final form of the Mark of the Beast monetary system, I believe they're going to give money away because welfare is a part. Everybody's going to need money because the money they're going to have by the time this third Great Depression plays out in all of the war, famine, and pestilence, the sword, the famine, and the pestilence that's coming with it plays out,